kicking off a massive week of footy festivities. Forest Place, now Footy Place, as fans met the mascots and got up close to some of the game's greats.
But I've skipped uni today to come here, so yeah, so excited that it's here. Dream come true.
That's awesome, awesome.
Who are you going to go for?
The homegrown footy legends just as excited as the fans.
The week's starting to build, isn't it? Brownlow last night, we've got some people starting to turn out here, just getting a bit of that energy. It's a good week for footy.
The stadium, well, I've said it many times, you know, besides the MCG, it's my second favourite and really, we should have had it here last year and this year.
West Aussies embracing the Melbourne might, turning the city red, white and blue, while the Holy Grail couldn't come to WA without a quokka selfie, the iconic furball making its premiership prediction. The Bulldogs and Demons were down to the serious business. 25,000 free tickets to watch them train on Grand Final Eve will be released by Ticketmaster tomorrow at midday.
But it is an exciting week, the Brownlow, all the events of the week and the Grand Final. I doubt it'll ever be seen again in our future, so let's enjoy it while it lasts.
As more than 60,000 fans make their way here to Optus Stadium come Saturday, every single train and bus across the network will be in operation. Services will run more frequently than usual and start 4 hours ahead of game time.
It's all about trying to make people get to the game as smooth as possible.
As for the crunch home, it'll be all hands on deck with services running for 2 hours after the game wraps up.
It's wonderful. For Western Australia, it's brilliant for our tourism industry. We're expecting over $10 million generated in terms of our local economy here.
Jessica Brown for 10 News First.